Hello and welcome to this video series on the Power BI Adoption Framework, which is about empowering every decision maker. I'm Manu.
And I'm Paul.
And in this video, we'll talk about the different support scenarios and options for Power BI. While developing a support strategy for the organization, it's important to cover three different support scenarios. This image shows a break-fix scenario where the lady's car is broken and she needs immediate assistance. In an IT scenario, when a user tries to access a report or a dashboard and they either can't access it or the application is broken, they would typically call the support team and expect a very quick response. The second scenario is where the car is functional, but the owner wants to make it look nicer and wants to make a minor enhancement to the car. In case of a BI solution, this can be related to ever-evolving business requirements, which require a change to the solution. The third type of support that's really important in a self-service scenario is real-time support. This is similar to the real-time support that sat-navs provide these days. They instantly reroute us if we take the wrong exit and show us the most optimal route based on where we are. In a self-service BI scenario, users need this kind of support when they start developing solutions and get stuck. This enablement support will increase users' confidence in their ability to develop solutions, because if they know that someone will be available to help them if they get stuck at any point, then they will be willing to take risk of trying something new. This can also be the most difficult type of support to provide because it's difficult to plan. Customers can possibly engage partners to provide this type of service. When it comes to break-fix support, there are two elements to it. It could be down to the infrastructure, or it could be down to the project or solution. Let's talk about the infrastructure aspect first. Every organization looks at this as a mandatory service, so IT resources and budget are generally available for this. From a Power BI perspective, in order to support users, the support teams need to have a good understanding of how the Power BI service works, which elements can be controlled by them, and which elements require them to work with Microsoft support. It's needless to say that a very quick turnaround is expected in this scenario, as the infrastructure may be underpinning a lot of projects, so the issues need to be fixed within specified SLAs. In terms of project-specific break-fix support, most organizations see this as a mandatory service as well, and the business teams that use the project typically absorb the support cost. In order to rapidly fix issues in Power BI solutions, project knowledge is quite important, because you wouldn't like someone to start understanding the project architecture when they're fixing an issue. Similarly, you wouldn't expect the support team to learn how to use Power BI Desktop when users are unable to consume data and the issues need to be fixed within specified SLAs. One of the best practices we've seen across customers is that the support team gets a handover from the project delivery team at the end of the project so that they have a good understanding of the project. Most business teams like to evolve their BI solutions as their business requirements evolve. So minor enhancements to existing BI solutions is generally perceived as an essential service, and it's typically funded by project teams or the support team. The timescales in this case are a bit more relaxed, so the support team can potentially do without prior knowledge of the project, as the timescales are agreed at the time of scoping. Having said that, the team can only be effective if they have a good knowledge of Power BI Desktop and service. When it comes to real-time enablement support, this is normally perceived as an optional service, but as we've mentioned before, this can be the difference between people adopting the tool or not. Ideally, this kind of support should be funded at an organizational level, where a team of Power BI champions or a partner is available to unblock people when they get stuck while developing a solution. Business teams can also fund this kind of support by engaging with partners directly. Whoever provides this support should be very proficient at Power BI, especially the DAX and M languages, as users will typically approach this team if they've exhausted other resources. It's really important for this support to be available in real time, as waiting for weeks or months to make progress on a BI solution completely defeats the purpose of agile BI development. Irrespective of whether or not it is possible to have dedicated resources to provide real-time support, self-service enablement options like how-to videos, FAQs, links to training materials, communities, etc. can go a long way, as it's all about building a self-service BI muscle.
When thinking about break fix or minor enhancement support, there are various options. Depending on the organization's existing support structure, this support can be provisioned in various ways. The first thing to remember is that Power BI is a software as a service solution, so any issues with the service need to be redirected to Microsoft. Microsoft has a support website where any major disruptions to the service are listed on the landing page. If it's not a known issue, then a support case should be raised with Microsoft. All Power BI Pro users can raise a support case with Microsoft, although the IT support team would ideally raise the case just to avoid duplication of effort. If the organization has a Premier Support Agreement, then a Premier Support ticket can be raised, as it may be governed by better SLAs. If the issue is with the organization's infrastructure, like gateways or back-end servers, then the internal infrastructure team can provide this support. And if the issue is specific to a project, then the internal BI support team or a support partner can help resolve the issue. You can have a dedicated Power BI enablement team, like we have at Microsoft. They constantly collate content, run lunch and learn sessions, and manage internal websites, which have lots of useful videos and articles. The team doesn't need to be large, it's just about having someone to focus on enabling people in the organization. An internal website with training videos and links to online resources can help massively in enabling users to support themselves. In addition to that, communities and online resources should also be leveraged. When it comes to real-time support, you can also engage with Microsoft or a Microsoft partner to provide advisory services. Power BI has a very vibrant community, and the product engineering team and the customer advisory team are constantly generating a lot of content to enable Power BI users. The Power BI website has a lot of content, including getting started videos, blogs, a community website, and a guided learning path. The Microsoft Power BI YouTube channel has a number of videos from various conferences so you can hear about new features and functionality. We also have a YouTube channel called Guy in a Cube, which is run by a couple of our colleagues. They provide regular updates on Power BI in terms of service updates, desktop tool updates, and industry and community updates as well. Power BI is relatively new, but Power Pivot, which is the data modeling engine used in Power BI, has been around since 2010, so there are lots of community websites that provide expert guidance on developing Power BI solutions. Some examples are Dax Patton's website, the Power Pivot Pro website, and Chris Webb's BI blog. A catalogue of these resources can help new Power BI users find their way when they get stuck. When planning a rollout and creating a support team, it is important to integrate any access requirements into existing new starter or role change processes. This may be granting or removing access to a gateway or its data sources, assigning pro licenses, or granting access to Power BI Desktop, to name a few. We've highlighted some of the options around providing support to your organization, and we strongly recommend deciding the areas you're going to support and to document them, so end users clearly know where they can go for further help. As well as documenting the level of support, you need to highlight who will provide these various levels of support as well. Changing links in the Power BI service, as highlighted in the service management video, is one way, but providing links in rollout communications and newsletters will make sure everyone knows who can support them with the various aspects of Power BI. You will find links to the slides used in this presentation in the description below. Thanks for listening, and if you have any feedback or questions, please leave a comment. See you in the next one.